Here we are, J Talk. We're still at the rugby. Place is buzzing. We're here with Maurice Otieno, a friend of mine. We first met at Meta, at the entrepreneurship panel. I was on it. Maurice was moderating. And you're the GM of Meta. Tell those viewers out there who don't know, what is Meta about?
So, Meta is all about helping entrepreneurs.
Yeah.
But to help them through connecting them to people who help them, either by connecting them to investors, corporates, industry experts, and people who are, if I can say, opinion shapers like yourself.
Yeah.
So we do that through various events that we host.
Yeah.
We've hosted about 22 to 30 events a month. We're a global platform, so we're in Hong Kong, we're in Beijing, we're in Bahrain, we're in Kenya, but virtually we're in nine major cities of the world.
Wow. And so you're an incubator of sorts, kind of.
So it's sort of like a capital club, but not for executives, but
yeah.
This is a capital club for entrepreneurs.
Okay.
And anybody who supports entrepreneurship. So it's more of membership. The space itself is just to complement entrepreneurs, a place where they can come and have fun or
share ideas.
Exactly, share ideas and love from
each other. Make connections, that's exactly. Fantastic. So exactly. How many members do you have of Meta right now?
Currently we have about 350
members.
In Nairobi alone.
Wow.
In Sub-Saharan Africa we have 400.
Wow.
And in globally we have 1,600.
So what are some of the companies or members that you're particularly interested in or excited about their potential?
I mean, some of the energy companies.
Yes.
I will highlight one called Pego.
Yeah.
So what Pego does is they monitor your usage of the gas, and if your gas runs low, it sends a notification to them and they refill it immediately.
Wow.
So you don't have to worry about your gas ending in between cooking and all that.
Yeah.
Which I think is a small geared towards sub-Saharan problems.
Yeah, no, that's a really great idea.
Some of them are like educational platforms,
yeah.
Like Eneza. So what Eneza does is it offers revision material to underprivileged people. Like for example, kids who are in an area where there's no internet, there's no school. So they get messages through SSB code, where they can use it to revise for their exams. So there are some of the exact examples that we have. Yeah.
So your journey to be GM of a place like Meta, a very hidden joint, you know, very interesting things going on there. What was that path like to get to where you are now?
I mean, of course, as any other person, after I finished my college degree, I went into employment. I worked for General Motors, after which I went back to Strathmore. Because I schooled at Strathmore, so I went back to work at the MBA program. But then I got to interact with a lot of industry experts and also entrepreneurs. So I always had this thing going in me about entrepreneurship.
Yeah.
So when a couple of our colleagues were coming up to join and form Meta, that's when I jumped onto the bandwagon side from below, filling it out to what it is right now. I'm happy to see that we have 300 plus members.
Yeah, going from strength to strength.
Exactly. I can't say it was easy. I mean, when you're building it,
yeah.
At some point, I used to walk to go talk to members. So, like, walk from Westlands to Kilimani.
Yeah.
Right now we have members, so I can afford an Uber.
Wow, that's a real startup journey right there.
It was a real startup journey. I mean, at some point, you were even discussing, like, we lay over our staff because we can't meet the demand, but I thank the founding team, because when we were founding, we had the...
Who are the founders?
So we have Aaron Fu.
Okay.
Aaron Fu is a managing partner at Nest.
Yes.
We had Safina Hoffman, but she's since moved on because she went back to Switzerland. Then we had Karen, who's now working for Anella.
Right.
My teammate Paul Muturi, who is a big social media,
yeah.
I can say influencer, although he doesn't call himself like that.
So are you a big rugby fan?
Yeah, I played for Queens.
Did you?
Yep,
wow.
This is my home.
This is your home ground,
this is my
right
home.
Here.
Once a queen, always a queen.
Yes.
So this is where I started from. Actually, when I was still in high school, Form 3.
Yeah.
Then later on, got scholarship to join Strathmore.
Okay.
So I joined Strathmore on a sports scholarship for 95% scholarship. School there, then later on came back to Queens.
Yeah.
Went back to Strathmore, and now I'm coming back to Queens.
That's great. Yeah, I mean, it's good to see the guys perform so well. Unfortunately, they lost today, but they're going from strength to strength. We're seeing some good results coming out.
And the good thing is that you have very young players now in the team. Vis-a-vis the other times when we had players who have been there like for almost 6-7 years. Now we have a young team. I mean, they're probably like in the next 2-3 years, they'll be like out there completely.
Fantastic. And wow. Yeah. It's great to have you here. We have a little, just for coming on J-Talk Live, here's your J-Talk Live t-shirt.
Thank you so much.
There you go.
This looks like you.
So there you go, J-Talk Live. Boris, thanks for supporting the show.
Thank you so
much. Thanks for having me on that panel the other day. It was a real pleasure.
Sorry,
I'm going to be catching up too, and I'm sure we'll be doing more interviews.
Thank you so much.